Hey everybody, it's Flame Flares! Last time on Pokemon Leaf Green, we got to Pewter City through Viridian Forest. Let's see, there is really nothing you can do in Pewter City unless you choose to go into the museum here. Just, you know, show you a bit. I'm not gonna, you know, pay to get in. It's like 50 bucks, I believe, to get in. 50 Poke Dollars, whatever you decide to call it. Something up here. So, what you can do is head down this way to the gym.
Let's look in the window!
Okay, anyway. This is the Pewter City Pokemon Gym. The leader is Brock, the rock-solid Pokemon trainer. Everyone knows Brock. I mean, everyone loves Brock. Especially Nurse Joy and Officer Jenny. Anyway, enough with the anime references. Stop right there, kid! You're 10,000 light years from facing Brock! Camper Lion. Liam Lion. If anyone knows how to pronounce that, please tell me. Alright, so I'm just gonna, you know, set up with Leech Seed, because I'm not really gonna be using Bulbasaur since he doesn't have an actual attack that's grass type yet, but guess what, Mankey has Low Kick, a fighting type attack that'll demolish rocks. Well, it can demolish rocks pretty much later in the game, like Golem, since Golem's like one of the heaviest Pokemon there is, at least as of this, this game, you know, the first 150, back when Snorlax was the, heaviest. Let's see. Leech Seed it. Man, I really just can't think of anything to say right now. Because this is actually a really boring fight, since I don't have Vine Whip. Otherwise, it'd be over, and we'd probably be on to Brock in his second Pokemon. Yes. Anyway, Bulbasaur grew to level 10. Learn Vine Whip. Alrighty. Bulbasaur also grew to level 11, which is just awesome sauce. I don't know why I said that. Light years isn't time, it measures distance. Oh my god, you messed up with your math then. But anyway, let's see. Yeah, I'm just gonna lead with Bulbasaur, actually. So, you're here. I'm Brock. I'm Pewter's gym leader. My rock hard willpower is evident even in my Pokemon. My Pokemon are all rock hard, and have true grit determination. How many references is this guy gonna make to rocks? That's right, my Pokemon are all the rock type. That makes sense now. F you, ha ha. Why are you laughing at me, Wilcull? Never mind. You're going to challenge me knowing that you'll lose? That's a trainer's honor that compels you to challenge me. Fine then. Show me your best. And we get awesome gym leader music, which they topped this. I thought this gym leader music was awesome. They topped it in Heart Gold and Soul Silver. I mean, they just topped it. I didn't think they could do it any better. And you know what? I went through that so fast. I didn't even read off, you know, Geodude's stats and whatnot. It is a rock ground type. Level 12 with the ability Rock Head, moves our tackle and defense curve. Anyway, this is Onyx, rock ground type with the ability Rock Head. The moves are Tackle, Bind, and Rock Tomb. Let's see how fast we can take it out. Now, if you're using Charmander, you're going to want to watch out for Rock Tomb. I can't believe that didn't knock it out in one hit. I smell a potion! Anyway, if you're using... Whoa! If you are using Charmander, you are going to definitely want to watch out for Rock Tomb. Because that's just going to, like, annihilate you. But anyway, if you're using Bulbasaur, as long as Bulbasaur is at least level 10, this fight is easy as heck. For your victory, I confer on you this, the official Pokemon League Boulder Badge. And look at that, it's so awesome, we get it in battle. Just having the Boulder Badge makes your Pokemon more powerful. It also enables the use of the move Flash. Outside of battle. Of course, a Pokemon must know the move Flash to use it. And there is only one cave in this entire game that you actually need to use it. Wait, take this with you. Receive TM39. That is Rock Tomb. A TM technical machine contains a technique for a Pokemon. Using a TM teaches the move it contains to a Pokemon. TM is good for only one use. So when you use one, pick the Pokemon carefully. Anyways, TM39 contains Rock Tomb. It hurls boulders at the foe and lowers its speed. Simple as that. And now we can actually look at the statue because I was too disgraced to look at it before. Pewter Pokemon Gym Leader Brock. Winning trainers Gary and Ryan. Because he's one step ahead of us. Anyway, that's actually all we're going to cover in this episode. Is Pewter City and its gym. Since it's a really easy gym for me with Bulbasaur. But, yeah. So, usually there's a kid that like stands right here and is like, Hey, you can't go out here yet. I have to take you over to the gym. Yeah, he's gone after you get the badge. And this guy shows up. You, talk to me. Oh, Ryan. I'm glad I caught up to you. I'm Professor Oak's aide. I've been asked to deliver this, so here you go. Ryan received the running shoes from the aide. Switch shoes with the running shoes. Press the B button to run, but only where there is room to run. Well, I must be going back to my lab. Or to the lab. Bye-bye. Peace out, dude. I can run. There's a letter attached. Dear Ryan, here's a pair of running shoes from my beloved challenger. Remember, I'll always cheer for you. Don't ever give up. From Mom. Hooray! Mom got me shoes! She got me new shoes! Yay! I can run! But I can't run indoors. That doesn't come until Pokemon Diamond and Pearl. Anyway, besides that, you know, this probably was a pretty short episode. So I'm gonna head in the Pokemon Center next time on Pokemon Leaf Green. We're gonna head east and at least, hopefully, start, Mount Moon. Maybe that'll be part 6. I don't know. I'll see you guys then.